Hi, we are going to explore the extrude function inside Onshape today. Before we get started, we need to change our workspace units to millimeters instead of the default inches that Onshape has. Once we have done that, we can start and sketch a drawing. First, we have to select a face of the plane we would like to work on. Once it is highlighted, click on Sketch, and then we will use the right navigation to bring us onto the plane. Select the shape we would like to sketch, and we can sketch anywhere on the plane that we have just selected. In this case, we will go into the middle. We will draw a circle, and then come over to the Dimension tool, click on the circle, and make it 40 millimeters in diameter. Once we are happy with our choice of size, dimension, and shape, we can confirm it by pressing the green check mark. After you click the check mark, highlight the sketch that we just drew, and then press onto the extrude feature on the top navigation tool. When we select it, we will get a drop-down menu that shows up. Right now, you can right-click on your plane to see what your extrude looks like. In this case, 25 millimeters is exactly what we are looking for. However, if you would like to change the depth, this is where you will go. You can type in a number and it will change, or you can drag this arrow manually and change the shape. But in this case, we will go back to 25. Once we are done, click the green check mark again, and this will be our basic extrude. So let's click on the front again. This time we are going to use the extrude function a little bit differently. We will be using it as a remove tool or a subtract tool. Click on the front and select the face, which is the top face of our cylinder now. We are going to go and sketch a circle again. Go to the center of the circle and draw out another circle. The dimension of the circle could be 30 millimeters. Confirm if that is what you want. This time, we are going to highlight sketch number 2, which is on the front face of the cylinder. We are going to use the extrude function again, but this time we are going to select remove instead of add. By selecting remove, it is going to cut into and through our object. However, if you do not want it to cut through your object, you can enter a lesser number here, and then now you have an inset. Alternatively, if you would like to add another cylinder on top, you would just use the add feature again. It will add a cylinder on top of the face you just selected. Let's go back to remove. We'll put in 20 millimeters, so it'll remove 20 millimeters on my cylinder. I am going to confirm it. This will give us the cylinder that I wanted to create. So here is our basic extrude and extrude cut features in Onshape. Thank you for watching.